Inside America's Boardrooms, the informational show for board members and corporate secretaries. Brought to you with Knowledge Partners, Diligent, PwC, Center for Audit Quality, Spencer Stewart, the Conference Board, and Corporate Board Member, along with content contributors Equilar, Meridian Compensation Partners, Wilson Sonsini Goodrich and Rosati, Donnelly Financial Solutions, and the Society for Corporate Governance.
Welcome to this edition of Inside America's Boardrooms. I'm T.K. Kerstetter, the CEO of Boardroom Resources and the co-founder and editor-at-large of Corporate Board Member. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the show, and today we're at the Corporate Board Member Annual Boardroom Summit. It's a three-day event that gets directors and CEOs together so that they can find out the latest boardroom trends and governance issues. Today, we're actually going to be looking at what I might call part two of understanding the Critical Audit Matters, or CAMS. And joining me for this update is Catherine Ide, who's the Managing Director of Professional Practice and Member Services for the Center for Audit Quality, or affectionately known as the CAQ. So welcome, Catherine.
Thanks, TK. Happy to be here.
We started on these Critical Audit Matters about 4 months ago.
That's right.
Okay, we didn't have full disclosure then, so we didn't know exactly where we were to provide full guidance, but I think we're there now. So the issue is that the PCAOB has provided that. They have, I believe it's three publications or sections that we want to make sure that people are aware of. Tell us a little bit about what has come out that's the updated information.
Sure. Well, I think it's important to just level set for a minute that the overall CAM requirement itself has not changed. The definition of CAMs has not changed. So CAMs continue to be matters that arise from the audit that are communicated or required to be communicated to the audit committee, and that relate to accounts or disclosures that are material to the financial statements and that involve especially challenging, subjective, or complex auditor judgment. Now, the PCAOB has released three publications recently around the implementation of critical audit matters. And the first publication is entitled The Basics. And as its name would suggest, it is a compilation of the requirements related to CAMS, as well as some information from the SEC's adopting release. And this is a good document for those who are just putting their foot in the water of CAMS and want to create a good foundation of knowledge. The second document that they released is the PCAOB staff review of audit methodologies of the firms. So the PCAOB staff compiled observations or thematic observations of the review that they performed of the audit methodology tools and templates from 10 auditing firms. And I think this is a great resource for not only audit committees, but also audit firms who are updating and refining their methodologies as a result of the CAM implementation. The third publication, I think, is probably especially helpful to audit committees and boards, and that relates to a deeper dive on the determination of CAMs. And it provides guidance as well as FAQs associated with the implementation of CAMs.
So what about the consistency in CAM determinations across auditors and audits?
So the PCAOB guidance is principles-based as it relates to the determination of CAMs, and it's meant to be applied in the context of the facts and circumstances of a particular audit. Now, auditors and industries are quite different, and naturally, we would expect differences in auditor judgments as it relates to the nature, timing, and extent of the audit response in particular circumstances, and that would influence the determination of CAMs. Now, we know that users of these CAMs are going to compare either across audit firms or across industries. But I would just caution those comparisons and encourage users not to make assumptions about the CAMs themselves or how they're described, because the PCAOB was quite clear that CAMs are unique to each particular audit.
Another question that seems to be fairly common from the audit committees or boards is, what is the relationship between CAMS and the company's disclosures regarding critical accounting estimates And then what does the PCAOB staff guidance say about those issues?
Sure. The PCAOB guidance indicates that the management requirement around critical accounting estimates may overlap with critical audit matters, but they are different. One is a management disclosure requirement, and of course, CAMs are an auditor requirement. And so while critical accounting estimates may be the subject of a CAM, we should not expect all critical accounting estimates to be CAMs. And the source of CAMs is much broader than critical accounting estimates. As I said at the beginning, the source for CAMs are those matters arising from the audit that they get communicated or are required to be communicated to the audit committee. So they're two distinct and different things.
That raises a question. Does a PCAOB staff guidance provide insight on the interaction between the CAMs and the company's disclosure outside of the financial statements?
It does. And so when we think about the auditor describing the CAM in the auditor's report, it would not be expected that the auditor would provide information about the company that the company itself has not publicly disclosed, unless it's necessary to describe the CAM or how the CAM was addressed in the audit. The PCAOB guidance does expand on what they view as publicly available information. And while I think we all would expect that to include the financial statements and disclosures, it also includes the 10K, other company SEC filings, as well as press releases, earnings guidance, and other public statements made by the company. And so I think that further clarification in the guidance is helpful.
Do you personally think that, from what you know about audit committees, that this new challenge is going to be a challenge for audit committees? And what is the CAQ doing to sort of, for those that might find it a challenge, helping them along?
Well, I think it's a great opportunity for not only auditors, but as well as audit committees to engage in a conversation, especially in our previous conversation, we talked about dry runs and that right. The firms were going through dry runs with their clients. So I think audit committees of the large accelerated filers are going to know what to expect and not be surprised about the process. And I think that that's a good thing. In terms of what the CAQ is doing, in December, we issued a publication that goes through lessons learned from that dry run process, as well as questions to consider and an illustrative example of a critical audit matter. And we also, on April 1st, had a webcast where we had perspectives of the regulators, both the PCAOB and the SEC, as well as audit committees, investors, and the audit profession together around a table talking about the implementation of CAMs. So the replay information for that webcast, as well as the publication from December, are both available on the CAQ's website, which is www.thecaq.org.
Well, the CAQ always has great tools. So whether it's the CAM issue or the other tools that you have, I would always recommend going into the website. You guys do a good job on that. It's important to me. It seems like we never cover audit committee work enough because there's so many other, whether it's culture, whether it's ESG, there's so many other issues that seem to be going. But the good news is you guys must be doing something good because we're not seeing audit issues come up that often. So I guess that's the good news.
I think we're all rowing in the same direction.
Yes,
so
right.
that does help.
And Catherine, thanks for taking the time to educate our audience.
Well, thanks, TK. It's a pleasure.
And that will conclude this edition of Inside America's Boardrooms. We hope you enjoyed the show. We'll be back again next week when we take another look at a critical topic that'll help you be a better board member or committee member. So we'll see you then.
Join us again next week for Inside America's Boardrooms, brought to you with Knowledge Partners, Diligent, PwC, Center for Audit Quality, Spencer Stewart, the Conference Board, and Corporate Board Member, along with content contributors, Equilar, Meridian Compensation Partners, Wilson Sonsini Goodrich and Rosati, Donnelly Financial Solutions, and the Society for Corporate Governance.